picturesque.
Classic.
Charming, so unique.
Inspiring.
Enchantment wall to wall.
What time is it?
Where are we?
Exquisitely antique.
A fanciful concoction.
It's so small!
The Grand Duchy of Sandemain occupies slightly less than 1 square kilometer of land,
making it the smallest independent sovereign nation in all of Europe!
You don't say!
You mean this is it?
Oh, how glorious, how positively Lilliputian!
Oh.
It's a miniature little duchy with a miniature little square. Rarely will you find such elation visiting anywhere. On each miniature stone of cobble, through the miniature thoroughfare, a staggering sense of history fills the air. It's a miniature little duchy where tradition, it seems, is vast. Rarely will you find such enormous reverence for the past. Not the tiniest thing has changed here, though the world may be spinning fast. The people of San Domain live unharassed.
Tucked away in a tiny valley, in a forest of camouflage, San Domain has eluded progress.
It's a dream.
It's a sweet mirage.
It's a miniature little duchy that has stopped our hands of time.
It's stranger.
It's
simple.
It's sublime.
Phoebe, look! A tiny violet butterfly!
It's a little quiet around here, isn't it?
Are you sure?
This is it?
Where is everybody anyway?
Don't no one live here? Where is the nearest telephone? I have got to call my editor.
Oh, this is divine. In keeping with its aura of old world charm, San Domain boasts no motor cars, no electric lights.
And no telephone.
What do you mean there's no telephone?
You'll find no modern conveniences of any sort here in San Domain.
No kidding!
Oh, how curious.
Hey, we ain't got a telephone.
Yes, but then how does one dress for dinner?
Do we know anyone in San Domain, darling?
While steadfastly basking in the glow of the golden past, San Domain has managed to maintain its neutral status throughout every European conflict.
Yes, and continues to remain at peace in a world of constant turmoil.
No wonder I've never heard of this place before.
Where's the wedding gonna be?
Look, Dorothy, 5 minutes past the hour. Just in time for the changing of the guard.
The changing of the guard!
Prince of Grunwald, like a page from a storybook.
off me.
Ow, it's my nose.
That's my foot.
That's my ear.
It's my ear. Let go.
Someone's coming. Get rid of it quick.
Bruno, I had it. What did you do that for? I had it and now it's gone.
Guess what? Oh, guess what? Well, you'll never guess, but... Oh, am I late? Did I miss something?
You're supposed to use the secret knot.
Oh, I was so excited, I forgot. I saw tourists in the square. Can you believe it? They were foreigners and everything.
God help us.
We've seen them already.
Oh.
Remember the knot next time or we'll have to find you.
I could almost touch it!
Belle, we were just getting started.
There is a flying machine. It's down at the border. It's there right now!
Quiet! Keep your voice down. Mr. Kisselhoff's upstairs. What if he finds out what we're doing down here?
Let's skip the meeting today. Go talk to the pilots!
We can't skip the meeting. I have an agenda all written out.
Oh, come on!
Not a word out of you. Not after your shocking display at the last meeting.
What did I do?
You insulted the royal family. That is the one thing I will not tolerate in this organization, even in the name of progress.
What did she say?
Please don't ask me to repeat it.
She called the princess a silly cow.
Well, she is.
Viper! Is it not our policy to only allow men of vision into our ranks?
Any movement for progress would have to include women, Bruno.
She is as pitiful an excuse for a female as I've ever seen.
For all you know, I could be better than all of you. I could... be descended from royalty, for all you know!
That again.
Something is wrong here. Very wrong. Right now, there's an airplane at our border. An airplane! At our border! Except it's on the other side. Along with everything else that people all over the world consider to be the necessities of life. And what are we doing about it?
We're waiting for the Queen to answer our letters.
I'm tired of waiting. My father and his father before him, they gave their lives to clockmaking. And both of them died before either took the time to live.
My father too, Val, but Rome wasn't built in a day.
I don't know much about Rome, but I do know about people who make a difference in this world. When they've got a dream, nothing stands in their way.
Yeah!
We better do more than dreaming, or we'll never get very far. We better let the world know what we think, what we want, who we are.
Ow.
People who think too small never get hurt at all. We better raise our sights. It's time to think big. We should be fierce and proud. We should protest out loud. We should demand our rights. It's time to think big. Let's take some action. Let's make a noise that they can't ignore. This is the future. What are we missing it for? Changes are happening everywhere. While we let life pass us by. Why are we here if it's not to dare? We'll never know if we never try. Are we just mice or are we men? This kind of chance won't come again. No more delay, the time is now. The time is now. The time is now. It's time to think big. Business in all the stores, buildings with 50 floors, carving in every room. It's time to think big! Well, are you with me? It's time to start a campaign. It's time to get out and bring the modern world to San Domain!
I know the Queen feels she has our best interests at heart.
Don't be so sure. Not allowed a single new invention, not to mention older ones all obsolete. If we want progress, then we have to find a way to make her understand.
She ought to listen to my baby cry. I think it's just about time.
But maybe an automobile. The finest clocks in the world are made right here in Saint-Domingue, but nobody knows it. Instead of just one or two little shops, we ought to have a whole factory
with decent hours
and a day off
and wages.
They tell us that we're better off without it.
And everybody else is getting rich
with mass production. We could all be millionaires before we're 30.
I'd like to have a million.
It's really a crime. I think it's just about time. I think we're ready to climb. Got to take control.
It's time to think big.
Let the crusade begin. We got a war to win. Let's get the hall and home.
It's time to think big.
It's time for progress. It's time to start a campaign. It's time to get out and bring the modern world to Saint-Domingue.
Now come on, let's think. There's got to be a way to shake things up around here. No more secret meetings. It's time we tell to the world.
Mr. Kisselhoff!
Wake up, Mr. Kisselhoff! The 20th century's here!
Oh my God!
Now come on, everybody! Big! Big!
I have an idea!
Quiet, Gabby! We're trying to concentrate! We can storm the Bastille!
We haven't got a Bastille. Right.
It's time to think big!
I have a suggestion!
Shh. How about a hunger strike?
Not bad!
Never! It's time to think big!
We must be brilliant! The world must notice us and be stunned!
It must be brilliant!
That's right, the world must be stunned!
I've got it! I've got it!
Please don't make me have to strike you!
Later, Gabby, please, this is serious.
How about a bomb?
What?
How about a bomb?
What? What?
How about a bomb?
A bomb?
The bomb's all wrong. It might blow up or something.
She is a viper. She is a genius!
I am?
It's perfect. We'll write a note. We'll warn the Queen that unless our demands are met by noon tomorrow, a bomb will go off. Just in time for the royal wedding.
That's not very nice.
I beg you not to listen to this girl.
Somebody could get hurt.
Nobody will get hurt. We'll build a smoke bomb. It'll be harmless. Besides, the Queen wouldn't dream of letting a bomb go off. Not with the princess getting married. She'll give in to us. She'll have to. Rudy. Can you build a timer out of one of these old clocks here?
Of course I can!
Bruno, can you draw a diagram of the palace?
Impossible. The palace is a veritable labyrinth. No one knows the exact layout.
We don't need a diagram. I can sneak inside, have a look around, and plant the bomb.
We'll never get past the palace guard.
It's a preposterous idea. It can't be done.
Oh, yes it can! And I'll prove it too!
Calm down, Gabby. We'll take care of this. Now, Sebastian, you know we keep the gunpowder. Rudy, pick up one of these fancy gold clocks on the shelf. Bruno, start to compose a note, short but forceful. Gabby, you wait here for further instructions. Great idea.
Here we go. I think I've got it.
Your hands are shaking. Let me do it.
No, Val, I've got it.
Changes are happening everywhere.
It's time to
Never do anything at all in Sandermane. I hate it here. I just in it. Your mother was a tawdry, grabby, American chorus girl who reeked of cheap cologne and married your gullible father for his money and his title. And when she got bored, she left him
with a broken heart and a tiny baby, a humiliation from which he never recovered.
Sophie! What's gotten into you? I never should have sent you to the Swiss. They're barbarians. Here, I've gone to the trouble to arrange a suitable marriage for you. And this is the thanks I get.
Grandmama, I'm not asking for much. I just want to be as happy as you were on your wedding day.
Happy? Who said I was happy? I was miserable. But just look at me now. I'm well, just look at me. Every time life deals me a vicious blow, when the world comes crashing at my feet, I count and rumble, heavens no. When I'm down, I don't admit defeat. Though I may feel crushed to my very soul, I arise each morning with the dawn, and I slip into my oven stall, and I put my emeralds on. I remove my crown from its velvet case, and my faith is restored in the human race. With my emeralds and my emeralds and my crown upon my head, I can go on again.
Don't you ever want to run away and never look behind you all day long? That's all I ever think about.
Yes, dear, no, dear. Don't you know that if you want to find yourself the dream for a tempest?
It just isn't fair.
No, it's not, is it? But that's the way life is, and we just have to make the best of it. You were only three when your father died. I could not believe that he was gone. For a week or more I cried and cried. Then I put my emeralds on, and I told myself, dear, you're not alone. You've a sweet baby girl of your very own, and she needs you to be with her, protect her from the world. You must go on again. Just look at you. You've never looked so beautiful. You might try to smile just a wee bit. He's really a very nice boy, and it doesn't hurt that he's loaded.
But when I'm with him, I just don't feel anything.
What is it you think you're supposed to feel, darling?
Well, I don't know exactly, but I'll know when it happens.
Darling, you expect so much.
Don't you ever dream of someone somewhere waiting just to take you in his arms and show you things you've never seen?
Yes, dear. No, dear. Nothing's half as thrilling as the thunder of my people when they shout, "We love our queen."
kiss you.
Oh! Be careful, oh, I missed your dress!
This is incredible, this is fabulous!
Gravy.
Gravy, where are you, darling? Come to Mama! Rip out my clothes. Woo!
Your goal is our world.
back here? You don't want to get lost now, do you?
You get lost, they're liable never to find you again.
Come on, Dorothy, let's get a shot at this.
Yes, the bed will stop the champagne jug. After the toast, the bride-to-be dance with the groom-to-be. I shall dance with the great uncle of the groom-to-be. And the guests will dance with, well, I suppose some things will just have to be left to chance.
Against my brain. Now, I'll admit this is a sudden switch.
dear.
Yes, Your Majesty, right away.
Sophie, dear, I'm so glad you decided to wear the necklace tonight after all. Is worse off than I thought. Myself. Perfect. Oh. How could they do this to me? We're not ready yet. We're just not ready.
Thank you.
I wonder if a bomb is such a good idea after all. My mother says we'll probably all get hanged for it.
You told your mother?
Don't worry. She won't tell anyone.
I think we should all quietly and calmly head for the border. Now, don't you start getting cold feet on me here. We made a plan and we're sticking to it. Somebody's coming out of the palace. Quick, look casual.
Princess.
There's rumors going about that she's lost quite a bit of weight.
Gabby!
Do you think anybody saw you?
Huh?
What do you think?
Wonderful. Beautiful. Perfection.
Just as I thought. Just as I thought. She gets inside the palace and what does she do? She takes a tour.
Yeah. one night, think of the gallant approach you will use. Soft and graceful and pink and lovely, she'll be waiting for you. When your eyes meet that very instant, my boy, you'll know what to do. Take her by the hand, she will understand. You'll know just how to woo her. You're a man now, you're a man. What night, two little duchies become the dominion. What night, what a night. I don't recall being asked my opinion.
Unless our demands are met by noon tomorrow, the bomb will go off. Signed, the people of Saint-Domingue.
Could we save loyal citizens of Saint-Domingue?
The loyal citizens of Saint-Domingue. Perfect. Here you go, Rudy. You know what to do.
Right.
What are we doing?
Well, come on, Gabby. The whole thing was your idea.
It was. I mean, it was. It was. I forgot.
You're really something, you know that?
What a night, eight from now we'll be telling our story. What a night, we're on our way to a moment of glory.
Who could have guessed that we'd be the best at such a defiant scheme? Everyone thinks we're tiddlywinks here, but we're a savage team. And this is only the start.
This is only the start.
Finally, we're on the right track now.
I guess there's no turning back now.
Night,
what a night.
Chimneys are puffing and windows are shaking.
What a night, what a night. Suddenly everything's worth the taking. This is the night.
So tell me, how did you make it to Saint-Domingue?
Well, you see, the wife here, she won a contest in one of their magazines she gets.
True modern screen romances. We asked the readers to tell us in 25 words or less why they would like to see the wedding of a real-life princess. And Miss Cora Heron here was our winner. Miss Cora Heron and her husband get their photo taken for the September issue. All right. Oh, no. Thank you, Dorothy.
And what was the winning entry, may I ask?
Well, I would like to see a real-life princess so I can have something to talk about in my life for once besides hogs and...
Yes, go on.
That's all. 25 words exactly.
Frank, darling. Isn't there anything to do here in the evening?
I'm afraid not, my darling.
I'm perfectly madcap!
What a night, what a night.
We don't even mind.
What a night, what a night. We'll come again, darling, if we can find it.
What a most enchanting carriage.
Wonder who they are.
Thank you.
Rosemary, just remember everything I said. Try to act like a man. A man not afraid. Cuckoo-comb, affect a manly pose. Legs apart, stomach in. Throw your chest out, hold your head up. Raise a brow and stroke your chin. Well, perhaps you better have a drop of alcohol instead. Try to think like a man. A man thinks he's great. Oh, okay, I think I'm wonderful. No, I don't. Yes, I do. I'm a great guy. No, I'm not. That's not true.
If you talk like that in front of her, you'll never get ahead.
Where is she? Gold Claude, she's very late.
Just relax, my boy.
There must be something wrong. It's way after eight.
Have a drop, my boy.
I'm sure it's nothing. She's just guessed. Uncle Claude, you know she doesn't like me! My hands are
nearly steady. Let me at her. Now I'm ready. No, I'm not. Yes, I am. To be a man.
Is a dazzling example of the feminine ideal this evening.
Still smooth as silk. You haven't changed in all these years.
Ah, maybe so, but you have changed, Your Majesty.
Oh, has my decline been even more cruel than I suspected?
Oh, quite the contrary. The years have added a glow, a shimmer if possible. You are more beautiful tonight than ever before.
Stick around, Claudia. We'll go upstairs later for a glass of sherry.
Ladies and gentlemen, Her Royal Highness, Princess Sophie. Her Royal Highness, Princess Sophie. Her Royal Highness, Princess Sophie!
Family.
Oh, no. It is we who are honored, and we humbly look forward to the inestimable good fortune of this blessed union. I know Sophie will find marriage a richly rewarding experience. Oh, just look at them, how they dote on one another.
Yes. Young love and good. Seeing them together certainly takes me back.
Why, Count, you don't have any champagne. We'll have to remedy that right away.
Oh, don't bother with me. Barely touched the stuff. Really.
Nonsense! On a night like tonight, Marguerite! I'm so ashamed of my stuff. Marguerite, where are you? You would think a new uniform would encourage a girl's pride in her work. Marguerite!
Here, let me.
Oh, but I couldn't.
Marguerite!
Don't mind, really.
Oh, but I shouldn't.
Marguerite!
Hi.
Gee, this is some party, isn't it?
Sure is.
Do you work here all the time, or do you just do the big parties like tonight?
Not exactly.
Champagne ever in life. Now that's something, isn't it?
Guess.
Boy, if they only knew what I was really doing here. Say, I can trust you, can't I?
Sure.
Well, keep this under your hat, but I'm not really a princess.
I know you're not really a princess, and I'm not really a prince. You're a woman, and I'm a man.
Say that again.
You're a woman, and I'm a man.
No, the part about the prince.
Never mind, forget it. Forget it.
Oh. Hey! Oops. Sorry.
I know you don't like me, so you don't have to pretend. I mean, not that you're pretending, but just in case you were. I mean, we're gonna get married tomorrow, no matter what, and I just don't want you to think that you can just not like me like that. I mean, I just wanted to say that, for the record, I don't like you either. I mean, unless you really do like me. Oh, but you don't. I mean, if you do, that's great. I could be wrong, I guess. Oh, but I'm sure I'm not. But if you do, that's great. Like me, that is. But do you? Oh, never mind. Forget it. Forget it.
So, you're not a waiter?
The Duchess de Fongois and the Countess Marinara. I beg your pardon, ladies, but I'm afraid I shall have to ask you to leave. You have come uninvited.
Why, my good sir, I'll have you know.
Please, madame, don't make a scene.
France, do you remember?
I don't believe I've had the pleasure, madame.
Well, take a good look.
Must I?
France, it's me, Elsie.
I don't believe I'm afraid I...
That's right, Elsie. You remember you used to bring me lilacs when I was crying? Let's just keep this between us good friends.
It's very good to see you again, Elsie. Oh, I beg your pardon, Duchess.
Catch up with you later, sweetie. What a lucky couple they are. Why, just look at all these lovely gifts. A stunning clock arrived just this afternoon. The detail is exquisite. Marguerite!
Yes, Your Majesty.
Hurry, dear. Run and fetch the clock. The one that arrived today. I don't see it, dear. It should be on display with the other gifts.
Yes, Your Majesty, right away.
We'll be quick about it. Hello, everyone. Hello. Welcome to our humble celebration in honor of our two little lovebirds. Do you think we can persuade the bride and groom to be to favor us with a dance? Maestro, if you please.
What is it, Your Majesty?
Why, it's uncanny. It's the unmistakable odor of cheap cologne.
Look at her, Myrtle. She's dancing. Isn't she beautiful?
I've got my hand on her waist. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. My hairy hand. On her waist. Oh my God! 1, 2, 3. It doesn't seem like she minds very much. She doesn't cringe when we touch. It seems like she's so at ease. On my knees.
God, get me through this, please.
Ouch!
Oh, sorry!
Oh no, it wasn't your fault!
Oh, God!
Look at them. They've got it figured out. They're not fooled by anything.
But a messenger has arrived with a note for you.
Not now, Franz, not now!
But, Your Majesty, I believe it contains an urgent message.
I said later! Do I make myself clear? Everyone, dance, dance, dance!
What a night!
I don't understand it. One minute we were talking and holding hands and everything was incredible, and then the next minute she's running around the room like a crazy person. There was that horrible explosion. And then she's just lying there. Unconscious.
Well, Louie, some women are like that.
Why haven't we heard anything yet? I don't know what I'll do if she doesn't come out of it.
Not to worry, Louie, not to worry. The ceremony isn't until noon. And I'm quite certain the girl will wake up at any moment. All the stronger for her ordeal. Everything will happen right on schedule. You'll see. Nothing is going to stop this wedding. Do you hear me? Nothing. Get some rest, Louie. You're getting upset.
Some smelling salts in your majesty.
I don't understand it! I just don't understand it! This kind of thing just doesn't happen inside of me! I tell you, she's the one that brought this upon us. She's the devil incarnate!
Your majesty!
I intend to get to the bottom of this. How did she get into the palace?
Your majesty!
I expect you welcomed her in with open arms.
Your majesty!
I'd dismiss you in an instant if I wasn't so perilously understaffed.
Your majesty!
Well, I can see I've been vastly underestimated here. Well, you'll have to get up very early in the morning to, well, it'll have to be very early.
Your majesty.
Yes, Marguerite, what is it, what is it?
Your majesty.
Yes, what?
She's awake, she's all right.
Oh, thank heaven.
Oh, dear God.
I must go to her at once.
I'm afraid she's gone back to sleep, your majesty.
Then wake her up.
But after everything she's been through.
Perhaps you're right, dear. Mark my words. I will see that these hoodlums pay dearly for this. They will rue the day they ever contemplated such an infamous act.
Franz.
Oh, shut up, Franz.
Oh, I've got to warn them right away.
I know we're not supposed to see each other before the ceremony, but I had to see for myself if you were all right. And I just wanted to tell you, I just wanted you to know that I love you. I'll see you later. You're so easy to talk to.
Your dreams away, and yet I
dancing with him. The greatest ball would be nothing without him. He loves me, and somehow he needs me. I've never had anybody need me.
Your Highness, Hugo made your favorite breakfast. Two quails, a smoked fish, those lethal sausages, and your ginger pears.
Oh, thank you, Cecile, but I couldn't eat a thing.
Your Highness, are you sure you are all right?
Yes, I'm fine. Will you deliver this note to Prince Louis right away?
Yes, Your Highness.
Thank you, Cecile. Right away. It's the least I owe. I can't go back. I just can't bear to hear them say, I told you so. See, Gabby, Gabby's just a girl. Gabby's head is full of dreams. Gabby, what does Gabby know? Gabby isn't very bright. They're right. I'm just a fool. It must have been the dress. I must have had myself confused. I guess I thought I'd make my dreams come true somehow. Wake up, there's no magic wand, no carriage ride, no charming prince, no happy end, no.
I would give anything to know what's going on in the palace right now.
This means a lot to you, doesn't it?
Gabby, have you ever wanted something so badly that you felt as if your whole life depended on it?
Yes.
For a long time now, I've had the feeling that there's gotta be more to life than just waiting in this shop every day. Day after day, for the rest of my life, hoping that today maybe something will happen.
Is it as if there's this little voice inside of you telling you that somehow your life is supposed to matter, that you're meant for something, something important?
Yes. Have you felt it too?
No. But I feel it now when I'm with you. Val, there's something I've got to tell you.
Val! Something terrible has happened!
Back for valuables! We're headed underground!
What's the matter?
She's come back, Val! She's come back!
Who's come back? somebody leave?
Is the princess missing?
No, not the princess, her mother. The princess's mother is missing?
No! She's here in Saint-Domingue!
That's impossible. Where did you hear that?
All we know is there was some kind of explosion last night.
An explosion?
That's what we heard. That doesn't mean it was our bomb, does it?
Of course not, with all the bombs that go off here every day.
Listen to me.
Maybe the queen is frightened of us. Maybe she's ready to meet our demands.
Why in the world would she be frightened of us?
We know we're harmless, but she doesn't.
If you'll just let me...
Will you just be quiet?
No, I will not be quiet. I have something important to tell you. I'm not who you think I am. I don't know who this Gabby is, or even where she is. Though in view of what's happening, I think I can...
What on earth is she babbling about?
Get to the point!
But the point is... The truth is... I'm not Gabby. I'm Sophie. Princess Sophie.
Really? Well, in that case, I have a confession to make as well. I'm the king of Romania.
Oh, please, listen to me. I ran out of the palace yesterday. I didn't know where I was going. I just knew I had to get out because I didn't want to get married. And you thought I was somebody else, and I let you believe it because I... Well, because I just let you. But now things have changed, and
please,
I...
Please, Gabby, enough is enough.
Val, you've got to...
Leave. Not now, Gabby!
My little voice keeps repeating, go see her. Though she's your mother, she loves you, she came. I can't. Where has she been? She just comes waltzing in. I should rave and rant. What if that she'd have shown up now that I'm already grown up? What do I need her for anyhow? I've needed her then. And I need as it is to admit, that's it.
The only dignified option is for us to surrender immediately.
That's it.
I'm telling you, everything will be okay so long as we don't panic.
If you don't mind.
My God! What incredible bomb structure! Dorothy, get a shot at this! We can't
can't deprive our readers of such a striking profile.
Hey, 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 don't move, don't move.
Move.
It'll just take a minute. How about one of the two of us? Smile. All right, now I've got a nose for this kind of a thing. Just what exactly would you say caused the explosion?
Explosion. What explosion?
Come on, gorgeous, level with me. I'm supposed to tell it, it was her long lost mother.
don't give up, do you?
Gay Templeton, true modern screen romances. Just one more question.
Miss Templeton, your commendably can-do American fortitude is getting to be rather a bore.
Now, would you say that the princess was covered with blood or engulfed by the inferno?
I never said she was covered with blood.
Okay, so engulfed by the inferno. Thank you.
Wait, I didn't say that. You can't print that!
Excuse me. Harden, Gay Templeton, true modern screen romances.
You're not a reporter, are you?
Born and raised?
Well, I have a story. A group of citizens...
Have they got a telephone? I have to call my editor.
No, but they could really use the publicity.
Sure, kid, but what's the angle?
Well, they did threaten to blow up the wedding.
Say no more, just point me in the right direction!
If they know you're a reporter, they'll never talk. What you need is a disguise.
Here, you can switch with me. Well, I don't know.
Of course, if you want someone else to get the story.
Where can we change?
Hurry, they're down in the cellar of Kisselhoff's Clockworks.
Thanks, Ace, and they said nothing ever happens here. Two big scoops. First, the long-lost mother item, and now this!
Long-lost mother. What do you know about that?
The whole thing was practically my idea. I brought her over here for the wedding. I've got exclusive rights to the whole mother-daughter affair. If I'm not back in an hour, wire the consulate.
Okay.
Go away. Oh, Miss Templeton, it's you. I beg you for just a moment of your time. Miss Templeton! Where are you going, Miss Templeton?
Splendid. Won't be long now. Hmm? Have a cigar.
No, Uncle Claude, I don't think so.
Have one, Louis. Each one has been rolled by hand by a blind Dutchman.
You go ahead. I might get ash on my coat.
Nonsense, Louis. Be a man. Have a cigar.
No, Uncle Claude. I don't want a cigar. I don't like cigars. Being a man has nothing to do with smoking cigars.
Very well, Louis, if that's how you feel. What's that in your hand?
A note from Sophie.
Well, what does it say?
It's rather personal, Claude, I just don't think
that... Say no more, Louis. I wouldn't think of intruding. Remember, I will always love you.
She will always love me.
Louis, I think it's about time we had a little talk about women. She's writing you little love notes now, but by tomorrow she'll turn on you so fast you won't know what hits you. The minute you let your feelings show, you're lost. You must keep the upper hand.
But I don't want the upper hand.
You don't want her to get the upper hand.
Oh, God, I really don't think that there is
an upper... My boy, this is war. You have to prepare yourself for battle. All the courage you can muster, you'll need your whole life long. You can never, ever trust her. My boy, you must be strong.
I won't listen anymore. I don't want to go to war. You're wrong. A man doesn't mean you don't hurt. To be a man doesn't mean you don't feel.
Nonsense, my boy. There are certain time-honored rules of the game that don't change. You'd better learn them now or you'll be miserable all your days.
Mm.
one takes the time to listen when I have things to say. I can't live that way, it's lonely. So it isn't any wonder when all is said and done, all I want is one thing only. I want someone I can talk to, someone with a lot of time to spend, someone I can talk to, someone who's a friend.
There's no Botticelli portrait, no Rembrandt over here, no one can come near her splendor. But it's what I see inside her, the soul looks disguised, that's what justifies surrender. 'Cause she's someone I can talk to, someone who will always know that I'm someone she can talk to, someone all the time.
I can just see us, when will the day be?
Laughing and singing, bouncing a baby.
She'll be the first one, followed by maybe
six or seven,
every other looking like their mother. While the seasons come and go, we will still be starry-eyed, sitting side by side and rocking.
There'll be times when just a look or a touch will say it all. Times like that don't call for talking. Time with someone I can turn to, someone who I'm always thinking of,
and I just wanted to say that—
Don't touch me. Don't ever touch me, do you understand? Not ever.
Times with someone I can turn to, someone I'm always thinking of, someone who I yearn to talk to. And Uncle Claude!
Thank you.
back, Grandmama.
Sophie, darling, I had no idea we'd come that close to losing you. Tell me, darling, was there a tremendous amount of light? Did you see God? Tell me, darling, so I won't be afraid.
Where's my mother? You can't keep me from seeing her.
I wouldn't dream of it, darling. Right after the ceremony.
Before the ceremony.
But, darling...
And that's not all. There's something else you have to do. A loyal group of citizens is waiting in the cellar of Kisselhoff's Clockworks. I want them sent for immediately.
Those hoodlums? Sophie, you can't be serious!
I want you to send for them. I want you to greet them as honored guests. Listen to what they have to say and put their ideas into action. Do you understand?
How dare you speak to me in that tone of voice? Where are my emeralds?
Send for them now, or there will be no wedding.
I don't know what's happened to you. You're not the same girl.
No, I guess I'm not.
You know, you really ought to get some sun.
Marguerite.
Marguerite.
No, I mean Marguerite. Come get me into my gown.
Yes, Rose.
Where's my breakfast? I want my breakfast, and I want it now.
But join us.
Now!
Yes, Rose.
And remind me to tell you how you're being exploited as a member of the proletariat.
How I pictured you. Except for one thing. I guess it's silly, but I thought maybe you'd be happy to see me too.
What would ever give you that idea?
Well, it must have been this part I played once. I can't remember the show. I was the mother. Of course, they had to lay the makeup on pretty thick. Anyway, in the final scene, there was this big reunion with my daughter, who I hadn't seen in nearly 20 years. You should have been there. There wasn't a dry eye in the house. You should have been there when we opened in Decatur. Oh, how I lived to hear that audience roar. So Ethel Barrymore was great, but I was greater. They stormed the aisles, they were begging for more. Since my appearance, they're renaming the theater. You should have been there, you should have been there. Between engagements, my pal Myrtle and I tour with a collage of the great heroines of the stage set to music. It's very Audi.
You should have been there. Growing up was pretty scary. I needed you to tuck me into my bed. A lonely orphan has a heavy load to carry. I had to tell the world my mother was dead. The day they picked the prince, they're forcing me to marry. You should have been there. You should have been there. I tried leaving thoughts behind, but no matter how I try, you were always on my mind. You're there, like the sand on the beach, like an itch that's hard to reach. Sound asleep or wide awake, I can't seem to shake you.
people would look at us and say we're sisters, cousins, best friends.
You should have been there, but I guess you had a reason.
I played Antigone, they swore I was Greek.
You could have tried to play a mother for a season.
I played Medea and Dubuque for a week.
I guess it's more than just abandonment, it's treason. You should have been here.
You should have been there. Store next to her boarding house. He was devoted to her. He used to wait for her every night at the stage door just to walk her home. The other girls in the chorus were getting wined and dined by Wall Street bankers and railroad tycoons. But Eddie, he'd always just have a bag of groceries for her. You gotta love a guy like that. Then, one night, she got some emerald earrings with a note attached from an honest to goodness prince. He saw her in the show and wanted to marry her. It was like a fairy tale. They loped aboard ship, but when they got to Europe, the prince's mother acted like she didn't belong, like she wasn't good enough for her son. Maybe she was right. I guess the girl was stupid to think she could ever fit in. Anyway, by that time, she was in the family way, and she realized she'd made a terrible mistake, that it was Eddie she really loved. I mean, the prince was a nice guy and all, but he was no Eddie. I guess you wouldn't understand what it feels like to know you're gonna have to spend the rest of your life married to somebody you don't really love. With no escape. Well, one night, she let herself get caught in the garden with the stable boy. And the prince had no choice but to divorce her. She was suddenly free. She wanted to take her baby with her. But they convinced her that the kid would be better off where she was. She'd have a better shot at life. She tried looking for Eddie, but the grocery store was gone and nobody would tell where he was. 5 years went by, then 10. Then one day I'd heard he'd enlisted and was stationed in Jersey. I wrote to him, but by that time he'd already been shipped overseas, and well, you can probably guess the rest. You're the only real family I got. I mean, she's got. I mean,
did that reporter help you write that story? Or did you come up with it all by yourself?
But it's true, every word of it.
It's a juicy story. I just hope you're getting a lot of money for it.
It's not what you think. I swear, I was broke, desperate, I guess, and I knew I had to get here somehow. When Myrtle showed me that picture of you in that magazine.
I'm thinner now since that picture.
I don't care about the money. I won't give her the story. I'll leave you and never bother you again. I realize now what a shambles I've made of my life.
It sounds like an exciting life to me. Traveling all over, always in new places. In a way, you've been a kind of hero to me. I've been almost jealous of you. You were smart enough to get out of Santa Maine.
Well, go figure. I've always been jealous of you, too, having such a cozy life here. I guess we do have something in common after all.
I guess we do.
Maybe I don't have any right saying this, but don't marry him, Sophie. Not if you don't love him. Not if you're in love with someone else.
But I don't know if he's in love with me.
Well, then find out now, before it's too late.
I should have been there singing lullabies and knitting.
I wish I'd been there on your opening.
I used to sigh and talk of nothing else but quitting.
I would have loved to see your name up in lights.
Me too.
And even though it's kind of late to be admitting, I should have been there. I should have been.
Thank you.
wouldn't be fugitives today.
Who is she, Gabby?
I don't know. Maybe we better let her go.
At least take the gag out of her mouth so she can breathe.
Princess Sophie to Prince Louis of Grunwald at noon.
It's a trick!
It's not a trick. Why would it be a trick?
I can assure you it is most sincere. Please come. The queen is expecting you.
Gabby! This is it! We did it!
No! Water! Let me go!
What's the matter?
Step to it, everyone. The queen is expecting us.
Well, come on, Gabby. Let's go!
I'm not going.
What do you mean you're not going?
I'm leaving Saint-Germain. I'm going to talk to the pilot of that airplane at the border.
Now, Gabby, just when everything's about to happen for us.
But that plane is still at the border. I'm going to be on it.
Gabby.
Anarchy! Total anarchy! It's all right, Cecile. Don't be afraid. Oh, thank you. Take me as far away from here as possible. I don't care where.
more together. Val, where is she?
In there.
I think it's time we met face to face. I have a feeling she's going to want to switch with me one last time. Oh, Mr. LaSalle, you've just been married and on the same day as the royal wedding.
Well, actually...
L'amour, l'amour. Been married 5 times myself. I met my last husband on a reconnaissance mission over the Isle of Wight.
May I ask a favor? Do you have room for 2 more?
For you and your wife? Why, of course.
Oh, just 1 minute.
Make it snappy.
Saying so, but she is rather late.
Your Majesty, I...
Her blood is not coming. I'm being... jilted!
Your Majesty, if I may...
Yes, Marguerite, what is it?
Your Majesty, I don't think the princess is coming.
What?
Nonsense!
She's run away, Your Majesty. I saw her this morning just like a peasant.
What is all this about?
dirty cap. She tried to hide from me. She...
You saying, oh, please, yeah.
Are you quite all right, my dear?
Oh, yes, yes, thank you.
I'm sorry I kept you waiting.
I was afraid you weren't going to come.
Please, hold my hand. Don't let go.
Never.
Sophie, I can't let you go through with this. The wedding is off. Remove this hussy at once.
I knew it. I knew this was going to happen.
But I tell you, the wedding is still off.
She doesn't love him.
Don't change the subject.
But I do love him. With all my heart.
Well, if you're sure.
You just stay away from her and she'll be fine. I'm terribly sorry for this untimely outburst, Count.
I must admit she had me worried by the thought of losing that dowry.
Dowry? What dowry? She hasn't got any dowry. Whatever you had left in the royal treasury, you drank up last night in the shop form of champagne. That's why I knew Sophie wouldn't let us down. She knows how much this marriage means to her people.
Louis, we're going home, but...
Why? I never...
We've been hoodwinked, Louis. It's my duty to make you a good marriage, and I am going to do it.
Why? You've no money either, you scoundrels. The wedding is off. Off, off, off.
Louis, do you want to marry me?
Of course I do.
Come, Sophie, this charade is over.
You do?
More than anything in the world. Louis!
And you don't care that I'm not... That we're not rich?
Sophie!
No. Do you?
Sophie!
Louis!
No.
What's the matter with you? Can't you see these two kids are in love?
You thought you could put a fast one on me, didn't you?
I don't have to stand here and be insulted by a decrepit old windbag.
Wait! If the only problem is that neither of our two countries has any money, then maybe together we can come up with a solution.
Sophie, please!
The people of Saint-Domingue may not have royal blood in their veins, but they're more resourceful than you think.
I'm sure if the people of Grunwald and the people of Saint-Domingue put their heads together, who knows what could be accomplished.
You're a fool.
The sentiment is lovely, darling, but the people need the royal family to
lead them into the future. Rui, Bruno, Sebastian, will you come forward, please? Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the hope of Saint-Denis. Rudy, tell them about the plan.
Well, your highness. Multi-phase plan to bring Saint-Domingue up to date, progress-wise, with the rest of the world. By the time the first phase is completed, we'll have electricity, telegraph, telephone, and you should pardon the expression, plumbing.
And the roads will be paved for motor vehicle traffic. By then, the timepieces mass-produced by our factories will have a high enough visibility.
Tell them about the publicity.
Right. We figure that by engraving the name of our duchy onto every item, we'll make Saint-Domingue a household word.
You think of it, do you?
Your Majesty, if I may be permitted to jump ahead to phases 4 and 5, this is where we clear off the trees from our mountain slopes and begin construction on ski lifts, stilted lodges, hilltop restaurants, and gambling casinos.
You're out of your minds, the lot of you!
I think you'll find it very cost-effective.
Indeed. I can see I've been a duke all these years, loving and caring for my subjects, trying to make our little duchy the only safe haven from war and corruption and greed. Here's what I think of your progress.
I tried to talk them out of it, Your Majesty. They never listened to me.
Don't you see? The future is unavoidable.
Whether we like it or not, things are going to have to change. But we have the choice. We can make Santomane into anything we want it to be, even something wonderful. It's up to us.
And what's to become of a poor, useless queen thrown out like yesterday's garbage? Should I be one of the nameless, faceless, forgotten masses whose bloody knuckles rap on the back doors of noisy cafes on winter nights?
Love, we sing the song, and this we shall decree. Peace!